Welcome to Shanti Peace for Mathematics. In this video, we are going to discuss about the finding the relative extrema and the saddle point for the function fxy is equal to 4xy minus x raised to 4 minus y raised to 4. What do you mean by saddle points and extremum points? The link for that is given in the I button. You can go and just inquire, or you can know about what is the extremum points and what is the saddle points, all sort of things we have discussed. We have also seen that what are the steps to finding the extremum and the point. Let us recall that steps. The first step is, so these are the working rule. I'm saying it is a working rule to find out the extremum value or a saddle point. The first one is, the first step is to find out fx and fy. The second one, the finding the all those points where fx and fy is 0. The third step, finding the fxx, fxy and fyy. All those points where fx and fy are 0, then all the points are called the critical points. And the fourth step is to finding the d, which is fxx, fyy minus fxy square. The fifth step is to decide whether at those points, whether the function has the maximum or minimum value. So it says that if d is positive and fxx is positive, then function has the relatively minimum. If d is positive and fxx is negative, then the function has relatively maximum. If d is negative, then the point x0, y0, where this fxx and fyy are 0, is called the saddle point. Okay, and the d is equal to 0, we cannot conclude that whether the function has minimum and the maximum at that point. So, we cannot draw any conclusion for that. So, these are the working rule to calculate the maximum and the minimum of the function. So, let's start to find out what are the maximum extreme value of this function as well as what are the saddle point for this function. So, first step, I am calculating what is fx. So, fx is finding the partial derivative of this function with respect to x. So that's why we have it as 4y minus 4x cube. Fy, it is 4x minus 4y cube. And this is the first step. Second step is to calculate what is the value of x0, y0 by considering this condition, that is fx at 0 and fy will be 0. So we'll have 4y minus 4x cube equal to 0 and 4x minus 4y cube equal to 0. So that's why this will give you y is equal to x cube and x is equal to y cube. So this both condition, by substituting the value of x here, we will have the value of y. Let us substitute the value of x there, we'll have y equal to y cube power cube, that is y raised to 9. So therefore, we have y raised to 9 minus y equal to 0. Now this we can write as y into y raised to 8 minus 1 equal to 0. Now this equation has a root, which is y equal to 0 or y power 8 minus 1 equal to 0. Now y power 8 minus 1 has the 2 factor, that is y power 4 minus 1 and y power 4 plus 1 equal to 0. But y power 4 plus 1 will have a complex root, so we will have only possibility is y minus 1 is 0. This is not possible because this will give you a complex root. Now y minus 4 is 0, so it has again two factor, that is y square minus 1 and y square plus 1. Y square plus 1 again it is not possible, so only possibility is y minus 1 is 0. This is because y square plus 1 is not possible due to the complex roots. We are working in the real domain. And therefore, y is equal to, only two possibilities are now left. That is, y is equal to plus or minus 1. So, all together, we have now three values of y, which is y equal to 0, or y equal to 1, or y equal to minus 1. So, the equation x is equal to y cube, we have, if you substitute this value into this, we will have x is 0 or x is 1 or x will be minus 1. So hence, if y is 0, we will have x is 0. If y is 1, we will have x is 1. If y is minus 1, we'll have x is minus 1. So the possible critical points are 0, 0, 1, 1, and minus 1, minus 1. Now this is the second step is completed. Now the third step is saying that to find out the what is the fxx. So let us see what is your fx. Your fx is 4y minus 4x cubed. So fxx will be minus 12x square. What will be the fyy? Fy you will have it is 4x minus 4y cubed. So that's why it is minus 12y square. And fxy, that is the derivative of this with respect to y, will give you 4. Now at the point, this critical points, we need to calculate the value of this, and finally we need to calculate the value of d, which is fxx fyy minus fxy square. So I am making one table for that. So first I am writing what are the critical points. Okay. Next I am writing what is fxx at that critical point. I am just saying it is x0, y0. The next is fyy at that point, x0, y0. The next value is fxy at point x0, y0. And the last one is we are writing d, which is fxx fyy minus fxy square at the point x0, y0. So the first value is 0, 0. So at 0, 0, what is fxx? We have calculated it is minus 12x square. So that is 0. Fyy we have calculated it is minus 12y square. So this is also 0 because x0 and y0 is 0. And fxy is a constant value which is 4. So this is 4. So this will give you minus 16 because 0 minus 4 square, that is minus 16. The next one is 1, 1. The next value is a 1, 1 value. So if you can have 1, 1, this is minus 12. This is also minus 12 because x 1, 1 and y is also 1. And this will be 4. So it is 144 minus 16 because 12 square minus 16, that is here, and that is 128, which is positive. Here it is negative. And minus 1 if you have, then it is again minus 12. This is also minus 12. And at the 4, it is 4. And this will give you again 128. You can just check by doing this fxx fyy minus fxy square. That is again minus 28, which is positive. So at this point, at x is equal to, at this critical point, what is your fxx? Fxx is 0. Okay, but the value is negative, so we can say that 0, 0 is a saddle point. According to our working rule that we have concluded in the first, we have seen that if d is negative, we are saying that x0, y0 is a saddle point. So that's why this 0, 0 is a saddle point. Here your fxx is negative and d is positive. So that's why at 1, 1, so at 1, 1, we can say that the function has the maximum value. And at minus 1, also function has the maximum value because d is positive and your fxx is negative. So that's why we can say that at 1, 1 and at minus 1, 1, function has the maximum value. And if you want to calculate what is that maximum value, that you can calculate by putting the value of the function, that is fxx, the function is 4 xy minus x raised to 4 minus y raised to 4. If you substitute that value here, so that will be 4 minus 1 minus 1, which will be 2. So the maximum value of the function is 2, and the saddle point of that function is 0, 0. This maximum is a relative maximum. That's it for this video. If you like this video, please press the like button. If you have any comment, suggestion or a question, please drop down in a comment box below. See you next video. Till then, bye-bye. Sayonara.